In other stories, Chief Executive of the Mental Health Authority, Professor Akwesio Osei, has advised parents and guardians to be attentive and observe the behaviors of their ward to enable early detection of suicidal thoughts or attempts in their ward or relatives.
Professor Akwesio Osei indicated that parents and guardians also need to undergo some form of counseling to understand the issue of mental health. According to him, any person who feels the need to attempt suicide leaves clues that, if detected early, will stop the individual from going through with it.
So you need to be counseled to understand that you should not wait until it gets to the last point. In fact, very often, anybody who attempts suicide will have given a signal, but you often overlook the signal or you don't even recognize them. Sometimes they may even say it, but I'm tired, I want to die, I'm going to kill myself. And you will say that, oh, if you really meant, you wouldn't tell us. But he's giving you something. So you need to be observant, you need to study our case, our relatives, and know that there has been a change, and that change could mean something significant, and then we intervene.
He added that there is an estimated of 1,500 cases of suicide annually in Ghana. Therefore, plans are underway to provide a call center for people with mental health who want to commit suicide.
An NGO did some work some time back. We have not been able to independently validate. But he had 1,500 suicide cases a year. 1,500. And that translates to roughly four to five cases a day. It's serious. Now, every case of completed suicide, we have about 10 cases that attempted and did not complete. Another 10 more for everyone attempted suicide, which planned but did not attempt. So you realize that for every one completed case, you have over 100 people who thought about it, contemplated or attempted. And indeed, my personal line is on the net as a suicide line. And every single day, sometimes 2 calls a night, every single day, every night, I get calls of people who are in distress wanting to take their lives. And then they went onto the net and found the number and they called. So it's a serious problem in the community and we need to do a lot. What we are trying to do is that we want to create an independent, well, not exactly independent, but we want to create a call center. So where people will call and it will go there and 24 hours somebody is there to advise them. Rana, it's my personal life. So if you call, for instance, as we are here, you call, you might not get me. And somebody might require that urgently, and if it does not get help, you might go and do it. So that is one thing we are trying to do. And then we train more people to be able to offer these services.
Speaking during the launch of Mental Health Policy for Ghana, aimed at ensuring the provision of quality mental health care to anyone living in Ghana who requires it, provide readily available medicines to people suffering from mental health and also reduce the stigma and discrimination against persons suffering from mental health. The chief executive of Mental Health Authority said there is a need to eradicate superstitions associated with mental health.
What the policy seeks to do in summary is that it wants to ensure that there is quality mental health care provided to anybody in Ghana who requires it. One, if you want to promote mental health. So once you are mentally healthy, we want you to remain mentally healthy. If you begin to exhibit features or develop features of mental health, then mental health problems, then very early it should be recognized and treated. And if it's recognized, there should be the opportunity for you to access the care. And so the care should be spread nationwide. You should not go to a small part of the country, Accra and Kafue Pantan as it is now. But wherever you are, Zabzugu, Tatale, everywhere in the country, you should be able to access quality mental health care. It also talks about ensuring that we integrate mental health care into general health care. So we should not see mental health as separate from general health care. It also wants to ensure that we have put a lot of emphasis on community care instead of institutional care, so that anybody who requires mental health care within the community anywhere, he can be seen and not send him to the hospital for admission before he can be seen. And then the policy wants to make sure that medications are available, readily available anywhere in the country where mental health services are provided. And then the personnel to provide the services, human resources, they are also everywhere. So you want to train more, develop more, so that everybody can get the care. The policy wants to reduce stigma end discrimination against persons with mental illness. We want to remove superstition within mental health care so people understand that if I have a mental health problem, it's an illness I have, which anybody can have, and not because there's my aunt is a witch and is.